I shot 11 under 53, and I had to lay up on the hole 18 for the win. So definitely a great tournament out there. Played a great round from start to finish. You know, I think the closest anyone was three or four at any time. So I definitely put the pedal to the metal today. Played aggressive, stuck to my game plan. I didn't play like I had a five-stroke lead. I played like I was tied. That was my mindset, and that's the way I played for pretty much the whole day, until maybe the last couple holes. I had to make a couple tweaks on 18 just to make sure nothing fluky happened. But yeah, played a solid round, solid tournament. I think I averaged 1075 plus for all weekend. So I definitely felt like my game was where I needed to be this week, and I'm looking forward to carrying that into next week at Santa Cruz. I established a game plan basically in my practice rounds, and I felt like, you know, I can throw all these shots really consistently and I can repeat them. So I think that just shooting a 10, 12, and 11, really consistent out there. I feel like I didn't make too many mistakes. I think I only had one bogey. So I definitely felt like my aggressive game plan, I was aggressive but not hyper aggressive. So there's definitely a fine line between being too aggressive and being too cautious. And so I think my game plans fit somewhere right in the perfect amount of aggressiveness out there. So just being able to have that, stick to the game plan, throw a lot of the shots when I needed to down the stretch, and hitting the island on 16 for sure was a big staple in the event, because that can be a two-stroke swing hole. And so I hit the island every round. And so I just was, you know, that was a hole that can really make or break your event. Just setting the precedence and telling all my competitors, like, hey, I'm here. You know, I play really well with the lead. I said that, you know, after day one. So I think that, you know, when I'm in the lead or really right close to the lead, I think that's when I play my best. Obviously, it's always fun to track down and try and make a move from maybe second card or from behind. But for me, I've been in the situation with the lead for so many times that I feel like I'm a veteran and I know what to do. I know what game plan to stick to when I have a lead, when I'm close to the lead. So I've just been in all the different scenarios and won tournaments in so many different ways that I really feel like my experience pays off, especially in a day like today. I'm going back to my buddy's house. We're gonna go eat and then hopefully go out, party a little bit, and definitely enjoy the moment, and definitely get back on the road to Santa Cruz tomorrow. And I mean, I've won two out of the last 3 years, so you know, I definitely feel like I've owned that tournament the last couple years, and I'm really excited to give me a chance to go 3 out of 4 years winning the Masters Cup. So my game, as you can see this week, was really good. I didn't really give any chances for anyone else to win, and that was my mindset. That was my goal: go out from day one and play a solid rounds to, you know, and not really even give anyone else a shot. So I think that when my game's feeling confident like it is this week, there's really no chance for anyone else to win, and that's where I'm at. That's my game plan, and that's what I'm sticking to, and I'm really looking forward to my really confident game plan and confident swing with all my sidearm, backhand, and putting, all different aspects of my game. I'm really excited for it to show here on the West Coast Swing, especially next week in Santa Cruz for our big rivalry match.